Have you ever experienced something paranormal? Something that defies explanation and sends chills down your spine? Today, we delve into the uncanny world of the supernatural, where closets aren't just for clothes and shoes, but may harbor enigmatic entities and inexplicable phenomena. Consider the story of Marianne from the small town of Rosendale. A typically quiet woman, Marianne began to notice strange occurrences around her home. Doors creaking open in the middle of the night, cold spots appearing and disappearing, and most disturbingly, whispers emanating from her closet. She initially dismissed it as the house settling, but the whispers grew louder and soon morphed into intelligible sentences, voicing threats and warnings. Marianne's story is not unique, but it serves as a potent reminder of the inexplicable phenomena that can occur in the most mundane places. Next, we have the tale of Robert from Manchester. An avid skeptic, Robert's views were challenged when he moved into an old Victorian house. The closet in his master bedroom, an ornate construction of dark oak, became the center of eerie happenings. He would wake up to find his clothes thrown out of the closet, and on several occasions, saw the closet door swing open of its own accord. The climax came one night when Robert saw a faint silhouette in the closet, a sight that turned his skepticism on its head. Then there's the account of Emily from New Orleans. Emily's daughter started speaking of an imaginary friend who lived in her closet. Initially, Emily brushed it off as a child's imagination at play, but her perspective shifted when she began to hear her daughter carrying on detailed conversations with the friend. She was even more taken aback when objects started moving around in the closet, seemingly of their own volition. Each of these stories paints a picture of the uncanny, the inexplicable, and the downright eerie. Closets, it seems, can be more than just spaces for storage. They can be portals to the unknown, homes to unseen entities, and the stage for paranormal activity. To summarize, we have discussed the experiences of three individuals who have encountered paranormal activities in their closets. Marianne, who heard threatening whispers from her closet. Robert, a skeptic turned believer by the strange activities in his Victorian closet. And Emily, whose daughter's imaginary friend turned out to be not so imaginary. Each account serves as a testament to the inexplicable phenomena that can occur in the most ordinary of places, reminding us that the world of the paranormal is as intriguing as it is terrifying. In the end, whether you believe in the supernatural or not, these stories remind us that there are always things that defy explanation, things that lurk in the corners of our reality, hidden in the most mundane places, like a closet.